All right, it's 7:30, so why don't we come to order? This is this one.
Oh, to the.
Regular person, right?
Yeah.
And there's not the other side of it.
Oh, they're both right, I'm saying.
So, I know this is gonna be a challenge, but you're Karen, and you're Nina.
I am?
Yeah.
I'm in.
Good luck. We have the minutes of the July 8th meeting to review and approve.
I'll move we accept it.
There's a motion to accept it, is there a second?
I'll second.
Keith, thank you, any discussion? All those in favor, please indicate saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, any extensions? Okay. Got the numbers for the current budget. It's still kind of early in the year, Sue, is anything startling going on?
Oh, you'd be surprised.
I'm surprised.
All right, Alden, Novak, and Dodd has ceased to support the assessors and tax collectors as of this year. So we're now going to have.
After all these years?
After all these years, so it puts most of the northwest corner in a little bind, but he sold his, that business to Quality. So Quality is in the position of right now transferring the debt. Well, they're supporting his current program. Come July 1st of next year, we have to move over to the Quality program, which is going to cost the town probably around $40,000.
$40,000?
$40,000, plus about $12,000 support a year for the tax collector and the assessor. There are no other companies out there.
Is that gonna be in this fiscal year?
No, next fiscal year.
Okay.
Quality is supposed to be coming back to us for maybe some different scenarios. Maybe we can pay it out over a course of a couple of years or something like that. They have not come back to us with that information.
Is that only one?
So, but Alden, Novak, and Dodd is going to continue to support the selectman's office and is going to continue to support the sewer district.
Well, do we wanna do that? Well, sewer district, we have control.
Well, no, we have no control, and all they do with the selectman's office is the budget.
Well, I know you'll look at it, but it just strikes me as the same guys already do everything.
Well, Quality, I don't think does payroll and budget, so. And Alden, Novak, and Dodd has already got it so that it'll go over to uniform chart of accounts for this town, and I don't know if the school is working on the uniform chart of accounts for the state yet or not. Yeah, because I think you're supposed to, I thought you were supposed to go before you were supposed to go. Yeah, so, I mean, so that's one of them.
What else? Roger was a good suit.
Pardon me?
Roger was a good suit.
Oh, thank you.
Except for Maple Island.
Pardon me, what?
That was just a mutter from there.
He's murmuring.
Happens to be Roger.
Pay no attention.
Oh, Maple Avenue. But you'll probably be dead and gone before that gets fixed. So that, I guess that was the big one.
Okay.
I mean, Webster Bank has given up municipal advising for bonding. Because of new SEC law.
What a world, what a world.
I know.
If you see something in the budget figures that are in the printouts before you and you want to come circle back to it before we end, that's okay too. What's going on in the treasurer's office, Chelsea?
Nothing all that exciting. We've got the 50% of the taxes already, so that's good.
Okay.
But other than that, not a whole lot happening.
Okay. That's good. Anything in the pension fund that we should talk about?
Well, we haven't found out exactly where we stand as of the end of the fiscal year. I expect we'll find that out within the next, you know, 30, 60 days or something like that from pension services. The last is that the state statute indicates you can only borrow what you're underfunded for the pension. So, and we weren't underfunded that much, and we might have gained it all.
Gained it all? You mean the stock market has improved that much?
Since we had the big loss.
In the Great Recession? What did it close to, what, 17?
17 and change.
Yeah, not much.
But that's when we started this process, that was still, down only in the 8, it's like 8,000, so.
Yeah, well, the day's gonna come and we're gonna have to deal with it, but, well, I don't think we wanna borrow more than what we're underfunded in, do we? Oh, no, we have to buy the annuities.
Well, if you were gonna look to the annuities, now the trouble with that is that because you're a government, you can't do that. It's not that you can't do it, it's just that it's not, the statutes only allow for you to borrow what is unfunded. So in order to go out for the annuities, you have to go and borrow. It gets to be really complicated. But because you could have a mass death, and so all this money rolls back and is not dealt out, it becomes part of the bottom line. And that, you know, you're going to have to get enough.
I'm still wrestling with mass death.
I know. Well, also, okay, for instance, I think it was in Britain, underfunded, went out to borrow the money. You know, like a third of their employees died. Of retirees, it was just a mess. Over the year, a lot of people died. And they didn't have to go out and borrow as much money as they had been authorized because of that. Because they weren't shelling out that money as a retirement benefit.
Our problems are nowhere near the size of what theirs were.
Right, so but basically,
I don't want to be funding that stuff from present income. What would you want to
do? I don't know, but anyway, it's not one of the things that a town or a municipality can go out and borrow.
Well, I'm learning over the course of time that if you have an elected representative, it's amazing what you can get somebody to get approval for.
Well, yeah, that's would be.
There seems to be an election coming up in a couple of months.
You might be able to get something changed. Well, they're not in session, so they can't get changed until they go into session.
I understand that. But as you know, because you sit on the same committee, we're hearing the school consolidation thing, but sometimes you have to go to the legislature.
Right, and so this might be something to, you know, go in and change it. Okay. For the purpose of, because, and you also have to get an attorney's opinion. Right now,
I'll give an opinion.
Yeah, I'm sure you'll get a written opinion to every bank that you're going, that the town wants to borrow from.
The town will help you, of course, I'll do it.
Are you allowed to, I mean, is there something in the budget that you can borrow, that is authorized to borrow for, but that we, you know,
it's
have
only
the money
for, a year.
For?
It's only for a year. It's only good for 1 year.
It's not designed
for anything more than 1 year.
We're switching from.
And every time that you borrow for a year, for instance, on that truck loan, we borrowed it not this past budget, but the budget, this budget we just closed out in 6/14. So it came due on 6/30. So in order for me to roll it over or to borrow the money again, I had to go through an attorney's letter, da 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 da, and so I was going to rack up legal fees. So I called the bank and I said, when can I pay this off and not incur a late fee? And they said, July 10th. I said, good, you'll have a check July 2nd. And I paid it out of current budget immediately, so I wouldn't have to go through that.
I was just wondering if there's anything that we have the ability to borrow for over multiple years that we could borrow for that and then use the money.
A bond, yeah, but you got to go to a town. Yeah, but you have to go to a town meeting for that. And then for a town meeting, it has to all be according to Hoyle and the whole business. Town has to approve it, and then in order to do, once if you get the approval, and then you have to go out and seek a lender.
And so we're resigned that, that changing the statutes in Hartford is easier than getting something through a town meeting?
No, I think, I think it would be easier, yes.
Okay.
Yes, I think it would be easier that way.
Well, the day's coming, we get to figure this out. I skipped over correspondence, I apologize, let's go back and deal with some really important stuff. The study request for Eleanor, from Eleanor, excuse me, for tax abatements, one is for Libby Borden for $130.42. Because of an over-assessment. One is for Jessup Trustee for $2,456.32 for an overpayment in two prior years. And the third is for another overpayment of Pam Collins for $18.87 for another payment. So I move we approve these requests from Eleanor to refund these taxes. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Keith, thank you. Discussion? All those in favor, did you get the numbers?
Yes.
Okay, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Any abstentions? Mr. Clerk, would you take care of that? Why don't you change that? Since I don't think it's October 1st, 2014, right? Did you send this? Thank you. We're going to need it. I think we're going to need it. So that brings us to the reason all of these nice people from the Board of Education are here, their proposal to improve the security of the motel. So who's going to take the lead on this? Meredith, has everybody met Meredith?
Mm-hmm. Meredith is our new superintendent of schools.
Hello, everybody. Hello. Prior to my coming to Norfolk, there had been a submission of a security grant in the first round of security monies that were offered by the government. Votel submitted a grant and received it. In that first round of grants, part of it was to hire an architect to do a design on the entrance of the school, because as it currently exists, a visitor comes into the school and to be checked in, and they, once they're buzzed into the doors, they have access to the whole building. And as part of the security study and assessment and best practice, the plan was to have the entrance redesigned so that people came in and they would be vetted, there'd be face-to-face interaction before they were then buzzed in or allowed into the school proper. And so we have these plans by, Kate Johnson was the architect by Responsive Designs, and she did a plan that would involve construction to convert some classroom space into a larger entranceway where someone would come in, there'd be a window, and they would show ID and have some conversation before being allowed into the building. We've just received an invitation to apply for a second round of money in a security grant, and our thought was that if there appears to have been a lot of time and energy invested in redesigning the entrance, and if the plan is to go ahead and implement that plan, it's going to cost approximately $60,000. At this point, if we apply for the grant with this project in mind, we stand to get about $30,000 paid for by the state in the grant. It's a 70-30 match, so if we apply for $61,000, the burden on the town, if you were to support this, would be about $42,000 plus, and the state would give us approximately $18,000 to $20,000 to move forward on this plan. So I shared the grant and the plan with Mike and with Sue, and we're hoping that the Board of Finance will give us the nod to move forward and apply for the grant, because I certainly wouldn't move forward without some indication that the town would be willing to partner with us in this little project.
This is contemplated to be money that would be spent in this fiscal year, right?
Yes.
And your deadline for the grant application, I think, is next week?
September 15th, Monday, the grant has to be submitted to the state.
I had actually wanted us to get together beforehand and just couldn't, but okay. Today's only the ninth, right?
It's only the ninth. We have done as much as we can in preparation, figuring it would be better to, you know, invest time and not move forward than to start from square one, but it's a pretty simple request. We have the design, we have the quote, we will apply for the money, you know, to do the entranceway. And in addition to the $60,360 that she quoted in her design, there's a phase three in her plan for an additional $1,200. The architect will provide some additional services, including reviewing bids and the selection of a contractor, meeting and having conversations with the builders prior to construction, overseeing the progress of construction, being available to review changes, and to review change orders, requests for payment with the contractor. So the architect would, for an additional about $1,200, partner with us, with the contractor, whoever we ended up going with to actually do the project. So the actual grant would be for the $60,360, and we would include the $1,200 for the additional services from the architect.
Which only makes sense to have the architect there to make sure that what's constructed is what was designed.
Yes.
This presents a problem. Well, this presents the following. We don't have the power to appropriate more than $20,000, just to remind you about that. So that, at best, what we're doing right now is saying to the Board of Ed, if that's the consensus of the Board of Finance, to go ahead with this project, we're going to have to go to a town meeting to get this approved. And what Mary Beth didn't say is there are other proposals for a lot more money than this. And Kate Johnson, who is just really good at what she does, came in and came up with a different plan. That's a $61,000 plan as opposed to, $180,000?
Yeah, that was the high end.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I just have a question. How much money is available?
They have not told us. In round one, anybody that asked for money, my understanding is, got the grant and got everything they asked for. At the time, I was in East Haddam, and we asked for multiple thousands of dollars, assuming like $500,000, we thought we would get, you know, significantly less. They gave us the entire amount that we asked for.
So this round of funding might not be as giving.
It may not be, but
we're not sure.
They have opened it up to the private sector this time as well. So I don't know how much money they actually have to distribute.
We can all, you know, you can always make that decision when and if they hear
right.
That they were approved.
That's where I'm headed. But I want the Board of Finance to say yes or no to the Board of Education to go ahead with the grant application, because if we're not going to support it anyway, there's no point in doing it. And what Sue's just saying was, there's a second part of that. Even if they get the grant, the town is not committed to do anything unless we go to a town meeting and ask for more than $20,000. I don't know if that's a foregone conclusion or not either, but I think that given what everybody knows happened in the school in Newtown, anything that we're being told to upgrade the security is something we have to take very seriously. So I invited the Board of Ed to come over and say, this is something they want to do. They want to know if they have the support of the Board of Finance. If they get this grant, are we going to turn around and ask the selectmen to have a town meeting to appropriate another $42,000, let's say, to finish this project, just using the round numbers, maybe $43,000. Discussion?
Just a quick question. Is there any stipulation on the grants that it has to have been approved by the town to pay
there
the
will be a sign-off sheet on the grant that Sue would be asked to sign, and the board chair, myself, understanding that, you know, moving forward in good faith, the expectation is that we are, you know, committed to supporting, you know, the town would be committed to supporting.
But we can move forward without town meeting.
Yes. And just as a little, you know, additional piece of information, the state law that went into effective July 1 was that every district conduct this security and safety assessment and come up with a new improved plan that aligned and complied with quite a massive template. Brian Oler was hired to do that assessment, and we met with him recently to go through the plan. And the whole focus of his assessment and plan centered on an entrance that currently as it exists does not, you know, begin to be best practice. So while the general plan was incredibly complimentary of all the things that are in place. The school is a safe place, we have many, many procedures, protocols in place that are, he said, far superior to many surrounding towns, but the focal point of his assessment and report was that entranceway. So I think it is something that the town certainly wants to consider to upgrade the school.
And this is strictly from the front door in?
Right, front door, correct.
It has nothing to do with the entranceway?
Yeah, the plan basically calls for, as you walk in, there's a first grade classroom right there, and they would take that space and current principal office space and convert that space so that someone would come in and they would go through a series of doors. We would move the classrooms further away. One of the nice things about this plan is that it does move the classrooms away from the entrance. Not only do visitors come in and have immediate access, but the classrooms are right there. We do have the room right now because of some declining enrollment and the Bridges program has moved. So we could easily move those classrooms to a little bit further away, and we could, I believe, continue with school without any interruption while some of the construction was going on. And while it would reconfigure the entranceway, it would remove the students a little bit from the, you know, anyone coming into the office, which would be an additional safety feature.
And I glean that this is almost going to be mandatory by the state?
They're not going to mandate
what we
do. They mandate that we do this, the assessment, and that we have a plan, and that plan includes everything from lockdown procedures, fire drills, evacuations.
Right, but I mean, but the state is looking into each school having some type of security above and beyond what they currently have.
Yes, yeah. Okay. And, you know, while we know that we cannot ever guarantee that we wouldn't have, you know, we could keep someone out, these are the kinds of actions that buy time, and they know that buying time saves lives. So the amount of time that it would take someone to come into the building and gain access to the school, every few minutes that you can save, and certainly this kind of an entranceway would make a very big difference in terms of the amount of time it would take a person to get access to our children.
Yeah. Great. Is there any technology required to upgrade or?
We in the first round of the grant, there was a request for cameras, for intercom systems, and we will be looking to upgrade that to some degree, but by and large, the technology that we need is in place. In this particular project, would not require technology other than moving the doors and reconfiguring the buzzers that allow folks in. So there would be no major technology component.
David, any questions?
No.
Okay.
That sounds good.
Yep.
Cool. I don't know if this has to be in the form of a motion, but is it the consensus of the Board of Finance and the Town of Norfolk to support the Board of Education in its application process here to get the grant, realizing that we can't appropriate the money anyway, so it's going to be that kind of thing? Is it the consensus of the board to support this and approve it? Because when the day comes, we're going to have the town meeting and we're going to have to include it in the budget.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's a reason. It's cheap. I mean, $61,000 is not a lot of money. I should say that on camera, but. Maybe inside his fist. But I mean, no, I mean, for security upgrades
in
electrical, a sense of a lot of it's going to have to come down the pike anyway.
Well, I think your question's.
Yeah, it is. I think for $61,000, I think we're getting a good deal. Okay. I mean, I could see this running.
Is that sort of the nod of everybody?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, I think we should support.
Me too.
And it's a safety issue. It's not. It's a sad thing we have to look to do, but it's necessary in this day and age. I'm sorry to say.
So I think that you're safe in making the application, knowing that if you get the grant, we'll ask the selectmen to have a town meeting to appropriate the rest of the money, and it's up to the town.
Wonderful. Can't ask for more than that. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Right. While we're talking about the Board of Ed, I need to add something on the two-thirds vote category, which is number 7 here, which is the Board of Ed managed to overspend its budget last year to to the tune of $90,000 on special education. And to remind you, we knew this, because George came over last year and said, this is what's going to happen. But Sue reminds me that we have to acknowledge this publicly so that George, in doing his audit, can deal with it, so that the Board of Finance doesn't appear to be so negligent and let $19,000 slip through our fingers. So do I have to do this as a motion, Sue, to approve that? So I move that we approve the after-the-fact approval of the expenditure of $19,000...
$422.96.
$422.96 by the Board of Ed and Special Ed in the previous fiscal year. That's a motion.
Which we had no control.
We'll talk about that when it's time for the budget. Is there a second?
Second.
Thank you. Discussion? We have to pay for special ed. They have to do special ed. There's nothing we can do about it.
And we have to have a note for the auditor when he comes to audit last year's books, indicating that the Board of Finance was aware of this.
Because otherwise, that'd be one of those footnotes we don't like to see in George's report. Any other discussion? All those in favor, they must say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Any abstentions? Carries. Any other two-thirds vote? Items that I can think of? Last item on our agenda is public comment. Any public comment? Bill, it's nice to see you.
No comment.
Nice to see everybody. For the business, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn this meeting.
I'll move.
Graham?
Yep.
Second.
Neil? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?